Joined now by Tony Loffreda from RBC to break down what's happening in business. And this week, Bank of Canada going to make a decision on interest rates. Tony, you know, we were talking about this just a little bit before. It is a weird time in the economy. And what does this decision, how does it play into the economy?
Tough to predict what's going to happen next. Like you said, it is a weird economy. But we don't predict any increase in interest rates. We only see maybe an increase in the first quarter of 2017. There's nothing in the economy at this point in time, except for maybe the housing market in Toronto and Vancouver, that would sustain or justify an increased interest rate. Because interest rates, you want two things. How's the economy doing? That's the first question. Two, inflation and the housing market. So there was some concern. But at this point,
there just seems to be so much conflicting data with how this economy is doing, right? So we have unemployment numbers that say one thing, and you know, we've got other indicators that say, hey, Canadian economy is doing well. We know that south of the border in the States, which were so tied to the U.S., and things seem to be going well for them. The economy is, and they're creating lots of jobs. What do you make of this, that we see so many things that say different things to us?
Well, I remember one thing, and I'll go back to, you know, my trip to China, where I met with the top minister, the secretary of China, and he said, everybody's concerned about GDP growth. We're concerned about unemployment. And the employment numbers in Canada were great. The U.S. made the mistake, I think, of increasing interest rates too quickly because their job market was good. The economy was doing better. But you have to have it sustainable. It has to be long term. So the U.S. was saying we'll do four increased interest rates. Now they're looking at two, maybe eventually one.
Is this one of the reasons why their dollar is so strong? That increase drove the dollar up, and that's hurting their businesses there too, people that want to export.
Exactly, because interest rates affect many things. They affect the housing market, affects currency, and obviously it controls inflation one way or another. But the housing market, at one time, the Bank of Canada was concerned about the Toronto and the Vancouver housing market. And this is why they've talked. They were always talking about increasing interest rates. And as a result, our dollar was doing always extremely well.
One thing when it comes to interest rates, obviously people who are buying homes have to look at their mortgage rates. And if we're seeing that we're nearing the end of this, you know, this time where we haven't seen interest rates very high, and they have, and like you said, you're not expecting an increase. Because we're not expecting an increase now, but we are foreseeing perhaps an increase next year, is now the time for people to lock in an interest rate?
Yes. We've gone from 1980s, in the early 1980s, 20% to below 3% at this point in time. Where is the downside? Very little downside. Therefore, if you can lock in at 4 or 5 years at below 3% or close to 3% or even just above 3%, depending what term you're choosing from 1 to 5 years, the time to do it is right now, because there's little downside and there might be some upside. If we see the economy, the job numbers get better, the economy doing better, the housing market keeps going and increasing and across Canada.
And this is a bit of a rarity, right? Because I think if you look historically, right, if you take the variable rate, you usually come out ahead. But now it's out the window, right?
That's a great question, Elias. I mean, historically, everyone that's gone variable has always come ahead. Mm-hmm. And big time, big time. Because rates, I remember in 1987, I bought my first home and I locked in at 12%. I said, wow, the deal of the century, 12%. 12%. Yeah. Could you imagine that, having a 12% mortgage today? That was our first home in 1987.
And you thought it was a deal.
I thought it was the deal of the century. So I think the variable rate has always come ahead. But at this point in time, the rate being so low,
there's nowhere else for it to go but up.
There's nowhere else to go. Even if the variable rate comes down, if you can lock in close to these numbers at this point in time, I think you're coming out way ahead. And the other thing, too, is your security. You want to sleep at night knowing here's my fixed cost, here's the fixed rate I've got, these are my payments for the next 3, 4, or 5 years.
That's right.
And you know that that's where you're going.
And
variable, you never know.
And there's that worry, right, that if rates start to increase a lot of people that got a low variable rate mortgage might find themselves underwater if it rises quickly.
Exactly.
I want to talk a bit about you, because you actually are just back from Europe. This is really interesting, something I didn't know. RBC, apparently, you bought a U.S.
We purchased City National, a U.S. bank that is specialized in entertainment. So I've been to Europe at the MIPTV conference.
And this is
festival,
in Cannes.
And what I can see to link it into the viewers and with the global economy, every year Cannes has many participants. Attendees last year, 15,000. This year, 11,000 attendees. Mm-hmm. Yes, there is a lot going on in France and with all the everything else we do know. But the economy, the global economy, is still struggling a little bit, what I've seen. Boots, like, I don't want to name drop, but people that would take $1 million boots have taken $500,000 boots. Mm-hmm. People that were taking those boots are taking tables today. So we've seen a lot, if we compare to previous years, a lot of, you know, people are careful with their expenses.
Struggling in Europe, right?
Careful, and we should not talk ourselves into a recession. Mm-hmm. And I want to, you know, I love TV people. It was a MIP TV, so it was a great week, a great time. And I'm glad to be back home. Always glad to be back home, despite the snow.
Thanks, Tony. We're lucky here in Canada right now.
We're lucky in Canada.
Tony, always a great talk. Thanks always so much.